Hello, welcome to the All or Nothing podcast. Our official sponsors are KR Couriers and Transport Limited.
Here's a mad one. Right, I get a message from this lad I was away with back in the day, Risley 2001. Kid from St. Helens, former boxer. You know, an Andy kid as well. But we had a little run in over drugs. He was on a visit, he put me on a promise. He had me waiting around, comes off his visit, goes missing. A few hours later, he comes out of someone's cell, absolutely blitzed, telling me that he got ghosted on his visit and he got a shorter of his mate. You know, the next day I found out he was full of shite. So I fronted him and said, lad, no, don't take me for a dickhead. You put me on a promise. You had me on a promise for days. You know, you come back and you got something. He said, you only got a weed, lad. I said, well, and what? He said, a little spliff with a little head change. You could have helped me out there. He said, I don't know you nothing. From St. Helens. I don't know you nothing, mate. I thought, you cheeky little cunt. Who are you talking to? He said, I'm talking to you. Next thing, he's in the pugilistic stance, doing the alley shuffle. You know, shadow boxing, and he was fast. I was thinking, oh, here we fucking go, we're gonna end up dancing here. But I'm a great observer, you know, of people. You know, I've watched his body movements. And all he had to do was, like, just slip, go under, and just power slam him, which he did. Slipped, went under, picked him up, body slammed him, started chomping on his ear. And he was screaming, don't bite me ear off, please, don't bite me ear off. You know, and I never had it in me, you know, to go that far, to go to that length. I just, like, just got up and, you know, let him go, and that was the end of that. You know, but years later, you know, he's got his shit together, he's doing really well. I've seen a few videos, he had a look of his profile. He's fucking fast, put a bit of timber on. You know, and he's knocking out people in this bare knuckle boxing competitions that he's involved in. He said to me, look, Bill, you know, it's a little bit of a grudge match. I'm thinking, I think grudge match. I could end up getting in the ring, hit this kid, and he could fucking punch fucking holes in me. He said, look, we'll do it for charity. I thought, okay, let me think about it. I'll do this for our Joe. If I do anything, I'll do for our Joe. I'll get in the ring and I'll get me head punched in. You know, as long as I can get bums on seats, get a little bit of dough for him, and I'll put it towards his caravan dream, and that's what I'll do. Whatever he does, it's up to him. But yeah, this is him. I'm going to think about it. Get into training, drop a little bit of weight, try and get a balance with his weight. I'm a little bit more heavier than him. But yeah, this is what I've been thinking. I thought I'd share it and see what your thoughts were. Am I too old? Am I going to get battered? Or is he one more fight in the dog, yeah? We'll see. Thanks for listening. Take care.